Well, hello everyone and welcome to my channel Visual Impression. Today's episode is about my new lens, Nikon 200 to 500 mm lens. And today we will discuss about this lens, its specifications and all, and we will go to the field and take some images and videos. And at the end of the video, we will discuss about its performance and how it works and how you have to store it and how you protect it, about all these things. So this is the lens I was waiting for a couple of years, and today successfully I purchased it, and I thought to prepare a video about it and show you guys how this lens works. So let's get started. So talking about this lens, this is Nikon's 200 to 500 millimeter lens, and it has a fixed aperture of f5.6, which is a great thing for wildlife photographers. And this lens comes with a VR, and its build quality is very premium. And if I zoom it fully, so this is the maximum length of this lens, and this is the hood. If I remove this hood, it is the lens. And if I place the hood, then the size of the lens you can see here, and its weight is 2.5 kilograms, and it costs around $1,300 in India. It is around 95,000. So it is, I can say, very affordable. It's not like affordable. 95,000 is not affordable. But considering these other lenses in market, means if you are getting any 500 mm or 400 mm lens with a 5.6 or a 4, then you have to spend more than 2 lakhs. So considering those things, its quality, its build quality, its image quality, its VR, and its 5.6 aperture, and its 500 mm focal length. So considering those things, this lens is not that pricey. It is affordable range, so everyone can purchase this lens, whoever has the opportunity. So that's why I told it is not that amount of pricey. It is affordable for wildlife photographers. That's why from the beginning of this lens till now, it is running very successfully, and lots of people are purchasing this lens. In fact, this is the most beloved lens for all the photographers, at most purchased, most sold item of Nikon so far. So this is about this lens, and it comes with a hood and a back cap and a front cap and a small pouch to carry this lens. All right, so I wanted to tell you about the feature of this lens. So it has a lock at 200 mm, so that you can zoom out and place it in your bag, and you carry your lens while traveling, it will not zoom out. And there is a manual and autofocus button, and there is a on off VR, means you can off the VR or turn on the VR. And there is a normal mode for static subject and sports mode for moving subjects, so that you can capture sports and birds in flying, birds in motion. So those things you can capture. So there is also a collar to attach to the tripod, and it's very heavy, means it's a very premium quality collar. But the hood is plastic made, but it doesn't feel like a plastic, but the whole section, means the whole lens, feels like a premium lens. So this is all about this lens, and you can carry it with your hand, and also you can put it in your tripod to capture subjects. So basically I have one camera which is out there capturing me, so that's why I didn't add the camera here. So after this discussion, I will go to the field and take some images and videos, and I will show you guys how this lens works. Thank you.
When I started my journey for photography trip today with my 200 to 500 mm lens, I saw a small green bee eater and it was so beautiful, and I captured few images of it with 500 mm, and this is 100% cropped image of the bird. You can see the feather and all very clearly, and here you see the video of it. I used it handheld, so you can see the VR performance of the lens is quite good. So while moving, I saw a common hoopoe. It was taking rest on my way to a river, so I took few images of it as well. You can see the textures of feathers as well very clearly. So when I reached at the bank of the river, I saw few sandpipers are collecting food, so I took a few images of the sandpipers with my 200-500 mm lens. So these images are taken with a complete 500 mm lens, and it is 100% cropped version of the image. So you can see the sharpness of the image and the depth of field also coming very nicely. You can see the texture of the sands as well. So I took one video of this bird here. I captured with this with handheld to test the VR performance of the lens. So the VR performance is quite good, and it's not looking like taken handheld. The lens itself is heavy, but it is not shaking at all. While moving, I saw a few sandpipers are taking rest, and it looks like they are in a meeting, so I didn't disturb them and moved forward. While moving forward, I saw a few blackwing tilt. They were also taking rest and collecting their food. While I was taking these images, it was nearly sunset time, so light was a little bit darker there. So I increased my ISO and took the shots of these birds. So I didn't see any kind of focus missing. This lens is working very well in low light conditions, you can see. So with this image, I thought to stop my photography for the day. And the end of the day, I saw sun is setting and it was looking very beautiful. So I thought to capture one image of sun.
A lot of images today with this lens, and I love the image quality and sharpness. So talking about the protection of this lens, don't throw it openly, because this is a huge lens and there are so many lens segments are there. So though they tell that this lens is weather sealed, still some micro particles, dust particles will enter inside the lens easily, and you will get moistures also. So try to get a dry cabinet that is not too expensive. It's around 10-12k you can get it. Otherwise if you have a bigger camera bag for it, put some silica gels and place somewhere where there is less moisture, so that you can protect it. But use it, don't worry, it will not damaged with fungus very sooner. And if you are getting few fungus, it will not affect your image quality. When you are returning home after your photo shoots, clean your lens with soft cloth, and do not touch the front element of the lens with any kind of lens cleaner or kind of liquids. Don't use those things. Rather use OneGuard or other premium companies lens cleaners and all. And yes, that's it. You protect your lens, take images, and share your thoughts with me. So friends, that's it. This is all about my new lens. So I hope you enjoyed this episode, and please do like and subscribe my channel, and share your thoughts and comments about this video, and stay tuned for next upcoming videos. Thank you.